Ask what are flow arts? You know, I'm a flow artist and I'm in the flow arts community. What we're talking about are different types of working with props, circus arts, juggling, spinning things, taking an object and doing something beyond function, like a fork, using it to eat is not a flow art. But if I have two forks and I'm dancing and transitioning in patterns and in the flow, well then I am doing flow arts. But generally, flow arts is working, dancing, playing, manipulating a prop.
Flow arts are anything to do with what would be generally described as juggling. It would be anything from poi to staff, something that spins, moves, and is interesting to watch from the outside and interesting to do from the inside.
It's a form of exercise. It's a form of mental discipline and physical discipline. It's a way for people to connect.
It brings together martial arts, dance, juggling, object manipulation, people, communities. It brings together just, I think, the best and the most positive of energies. So much sharing has come out of it and so much great community has come out of it. I think that there is no real beginning or end. I think it's part of the human story.
I think the term flow arts came from the United States, but I think the history of the activities that are defined as flow arts came from New Zealand, came from Hawaii, came from martial arts, came from all over the place.
I think that there isn't a single seed for the flow arts, and it's not even a tree, it's like a whole garden, and there's a lot of seeds, and some of those seeds are traditional forms of martial arts, like for poi was the Maoris of New Zealand, and for staff, we saw staff spinning basically in pretty much every culture that has some sort of, you know, martial or defense system. Do all people use the word flow arts? I think there are a lot of people who align themselves with it, and I think that they really like how all-encompassing the term is. As with any nomenclature, you're going to have a bunch of people who are going to say, that's just not me, I'm not an artist, or I don't do this for flow, I do this for just purely technical mastery. So there's definitely been some people that you might fall under the term, but who have not really chosen to embrace it, and that's okay. Like, the more terms, the merrier.
Flow is as simple as it is complicated, simultaneously elusive and ever-present. There are distinctly common threads in the cultural experience of flow, but the intimate and personal nature of the flow state results in remarkably diverse definitions. Regardless of how difficult it is to explain and agree on exactly what flow is, the majority of the spinning community has slowly come to use the term to identify their art form.
from a psychological point of view, the flow state is a heightened state of mental awareness where you feel engaged in what you're doing and you're confident and you know what to do, where your work is becoming very natural and it's energizing. You thrive on it, and so it becomes self-perpetuating. But the flow state exists across all disciplines, in academia, in the arts, in sports. And that flow experience is something that is easy to tap into through the flow arts, through object manipulation, prop dance, juggling, etc. And so I think it was natural for that term to come up and kind of grab all these eclectic arts in and give them an umbrella.
You know, it's where your skill level is matched by the activity that you're doing, and you know, if it's too challenging, then you get frustrated. If it's too easy, you get bored. When it's just a couple of steps above your ability, you can just, you know, be in the zone and focus on it, and everything else melts away. That is the state of mind known as flow.
Some of the aspects of being in flow are mindfulness aspects, qualities of present moment awareness, qualities of non-judgment, qualities of acceptance, qualities of attention on purpose. So if we're able to cultivate those qualities and practice those through flow activities or flow arts, we're able to bring those characteristics into our day-to-day lives. It could be when you're driving your car, when you're gardening, when you're playing a sport, when you're juggling. It's those moments where we become so involved in the task at hand and we just do them for the sake of doing them because they're pleasurable. Those are some key aspects of the psychology of flow. On the neuroscience aspect, we experience what's known as transient hypofrontalis. What this means is that there's a decrease in activation and blood flow to areas related to the frontal cortex. So this is higher decision making. This is our self-consciousness. This is our spatial and time awareness. And what this means is that our brain becomes very economical and only blood flow is occurring in areas that are absolutely necessary for the activity that we're engaged in at the moment.
In flow arts, the flow is allowing yourself to go, allowing yourself to be free, allowing whatever it is that's out there to come through you, releasing your expectations or your judgments and just letting it go.
Modern phenomena of a fire or flow festival is many things, but a few key elements kind of define it. One of those is workshops, the sharing of skill and ability with the group. The workshops also have discussions. You have your skill prop-based workshops, but oftentimes at flow festivals they have discussion, quantum mechanics or yoga and health. Then we have the fire circle. At night, generally you're talking music, live music or a DJ, and when they're ready, fire artists fuel up and go into a fire circle, flow, jam with each other, entertain the crowd. It's informal performance. It's not a formal performance. Everyone's kind of on the same level. Shows, performance from a formal show of the special guests, to a renegade show where anyone comes up and it's rah, and they're both great for different reasons. So there's performances all around the world, all around the country. There's this common thread with spinners and flow artists, people that have connected to flow. And that is an instant bond that you share with hundreds of people for a weekend. And they're the best people. You know, I leave my staffs, my clubs, my props out, and walk away for a couple hours. You know, trusting the group because they're good people.
Flow arts festivals are like summer camp for flow artists. They tend to be fairly intimate, ranging from like 100 to like 700 or 800 people. And they're an amazing way for people to share skills, learn from each other, and build community. Kind of like what the coffee shop does for your neighborhood, you know, but on a much wider scale. Flow arts festivals are not just a US-based phenomenon. They are happening in Japan, they happen in Singapore, they happen all over Europe and Australia. They're definitely a worldwide phenomenon.
A flow arts festival is a great place to go for an introduction into how to spin poi, how to spin staff, how to do hula hoop, how to engage in all these object manipulation activities, and to learn and to share and to connect with other people.
When I come to these fire festivals, I get to be myself. I get to clown around in the fire circle. I get to like dance fully and be free and express myself. And every one of them I come to, I feel like I get a little bit more of me, or I get this like kind of peak moment of expressivity and being with community. It's given me a place to feel comfortable being exactly who I am. I've got so many friends here, it's ridiculous. Like, it just gets better and better and better.
A lot of my best friends are part of this whole circuit now, and where we meet and gather and play is at events like this. And it brings us together, it tightens our own bonds, and it forms opportunities for collaboration and creative projects, and it's just been a launch pad into unknown and new dimensions.
Flow arts festivals usually take place outdoors, at Boy Scout camps sometimes, where everybody's in nature as well as working on their art together. It really creates an opportunity for us to reconnect with the community as well as with the great outdoors.
They've changed my life, and I know that they've changed many, many others.
Arts came to me at a really pivotal time in my life. I still had a lot of really self-destructive adolescence that I was clinging to, and it became like a real rock for me. And like my life, my personal life just improved in so many ways after I really got into my art form and really had that outlet that I think it's made me a better, more well-rounded person. Like just to be in the presence of our community, to be in this kind of like collaborative space.
Juggling has affected me a lot. When I really started to get into juggling, I was like a sophomore in high school, freshman in high school, and I weighed like over 300 pounds. So I was like, you know, I wasn't very active, sat in front of the TV a lot, and juggling got me off the couch and, you know, more active and more involved with my own body. And yeah, I lost over 100 pounds because of that, and gained confidence in myself and confidence in my body, and everything has changed, a lot of stuff. Yeah, emotional. Yeah.
I started spinning poi after my husband passed, after fighting with leukemia. And it was a couple different things of why I did poi. One was I wanted to learn a new skill and meditate and get away from the world, and this was a way to do that. It was also a way to show my boys, who are 13 and 16, that practice gets something better. You don't walk in and learn how to do something and do it well right off. And then as you want to grow, you learn and you practice and you practice. And it's fun to practice instead of being a drudgery. And I really wanted to show them that, and I'm enjoying it. I'm doing it all the time. I actually carry my poi almost everywhere.
We've been teaching flow arts to kids for about 4 or 5 years, and a lot of kids go through life sort of being forced to learn this or that, but when we start to introduce them to flow arts, they realize that the ideas of practice and repetition and discipline can really help them learn anything, and this can help them in school and in their lives and all kinds of things.
When we share with kids that there's no rules to flow arts, that really you can do whatever you want if it feels good, they start to realize it's different than sports or different than something that has rules.
Learning flow arts is useful, I think, no matter how old you are or where you are in your life. I know a lot of people who have used it for physical therapy and also to basically get over addictions. A lot of people have swapped very unhealthy addictions for this very healthy one.
I am absolutely a different person because of flow arts. The way I think about the world, the way I treat and interact with the people that are in it have all changed significantly in the last 2 years, and it's because of the flow arts that I've been involved with.
Future of flow arts, I think that it's limitless, and a lot of it depends on how much we can grow together as a community and allow for diversity within the community.
I think of flow arts as kind of like where breakdancing was in the 80s, or yoga was in the 80s or 90s, where it's still pretty small and not very well known, but I see it gaining momentum.
It's exploding, it's growing. We're like seeing our festivals multiply by number and multiply by population.
I hope that flow arts becomes so popular that it becomes a really respected art form, standing strong amongst the other arts, amongst graffiti, amongst dance, amongst physical print media, that you'll be able to go to a dance show and you'll see someone in that show doing flow arts.
I mean, it's my hope that the idea of flow arts and the disciplines inside flow arts become a more common part of physical education. That it's another option beyond an organized sport or a competitive sport, that it's a way that people accept that you can move your body in all kinds of ways, and a non-competitive, creative way that can be focused around an object. It's my hope that that becomes an accepted idea and really common around, and that it's an alternative to sports in physical education.
Something and spin it. Everybody. Something. There's something out there you can spin. You know. Do it.
got them open all over town. Strictly bitch, you don't play around, cover much ground. The obsessive, compulsive
behavior, I can stop thinking about it, and I just do it every day, and I practice every day, I talk to people about it every day, and it's kind of helping. It's just so good, and I want to share it with everybody else, and you know, it just comes out. In the stash, stacking up the cash, back when it comes to the gas. By no means average, it's almost she's got to have it. Baby, you're a perfect 10, I wanna get in, can I get down so I can win?
You know, nobody knew what fire spinning was 10, 15 years ago, and now, like, people on the street, they probably have heard of fire spinners or fire spinning, or say, oh, I've seen that in Hawaii.
Bag it up. I like the way you work it.
No diggity, no diggity.
Like to bag it up.
Yeah. Ooh.
She's got class and style. Street knowledge by the pile.
Ooh.
Baby, never act wild. Very low key.
You can learn poi by taking a move, breaking it down, doing it with one hand and then the other hand, assembling the pieces, and then integrating that. Well, you have then a little metaphor for how to learn anything, and how to tackle a challenge without being frustrated or overwhelmed. And so by learning flow arts, I think the real lesson is, how can we take it to our lives? How can we learn and do other things better?
Trump tight all day, every day. You're blowing my mind, maybe in time. Maybe I'll get you in my ride. I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
One of the main things I find we have all in common is wanting a better and a more productive life outside of the spinning, and just cultivating ourselves and the community, and like living like more positive and more ethical, and just living a better and productive life and more healthier life.
Flow arts feel good. They feel great.
In full effect, uh-huh. Tamika in full effect, yeah.